What's up, Midpoint? My name is Michael Breedlove, and I am the student pastor at our Kenner campus. So I want to start out today with a question. How many of you have ever been to a brand new school for the very first time and you didn't know anybody? Anybody? Okay. Now that can be pretty intimidating, right? So I want to share a little testimony, okay? When I was younger, I went to the same exact school, a private school, really small school, from first through sixth grade. And I knew everyone. We played sports together, we were on the same teams. Every year we'd show up the next year and all the same students would be there. Randomly, there'd be a new person. But for the most part, I had the same friends for 6 years. And then, in between my sixth and seventh grade year, my parents split up and they divorced. And because of that, I had to go to a brand new school. It was a public school, it was a very big school. And I went from being the athlete, from being known, from having a lot of friends, to knowing absolutely nobody. And I just wanted to fit in, right? We've all kind of been there, we just want to fit in. And so I decided I wanted to fit in like everybody else and look like everybody else, so I got a haircut like everybody else. And then I went out and bought some jeans, some Paco jeans. Now, these jeans, not only were they baggy, but I also had to sag them because that's what everybody else is doing. So I wore them kind of like, I could barely walk. They were sagging so much I could barely walk. And I looked absolutely ridiculous. But the truth is, I did all these things because I wanted to fit in. But at the end of the day, I still didn't fit in. I still was not who I was supposed to be, and I was left just kind of empty, right? Now, I know I'm not the only one who has done that before and who thought that they just wanted to fit in like everyone else. Maybe you've been there. Maybe you got a haircut like somebody else, or maybe you bought some clothes that you really didn't like, but you decided to wear because everyone else was wearing them. Or maybe you decided to smoke or drink because somebody else was doing it and you thought it would help you fit in, but in reality, they ended up just making fun of you and laughing at you and you still didn't fit in. Why do we do these things? Why do we make decisions like that just to try and fit in? Maybe it's because we are afraid of not fitting in, afraid of being laughed at. Maybe we're afraid of drawing more attention to ourselves if we're different. Maybe we are just afraid of that word, of being different. Now, don't get me wrong. It's not necessarily wrong for us to kind of go with the trends and try and dress like the trends. But, however, I will say this. If we're being honest with ourselves, there are times when the pressures of fitting in are greater than our desires to be who God has made us to be. That's when we run into problems. Last week, we learned about Jesus, right? And Jesus was distinct. Jesus is distinct. And he is not just like anyone else. He is like nobody else. Why? Because he is God. Now that is good news for us. It's really good news. And today I want us to really understand something and know something and hear something. So if you hear or listen to nothing else I say, I just want you to hear and know this, okay? God made you distinct. God made you distinct. Now let's look at the Bible as we kind of dive into that statement a little bit. I want us to look at a passage in the book of John. Now, John is one of the four gospels, and in the book of John, John talks about this guy, also named John, John the Baptist, okay? Now, John the Baptist was somebody who was pretty distinct, and if we're being honest, he was kind of a little weird. I'm talking about like eating locusts in the desert, kind of weird person. Yeah, that's really weird. So that's who John is. And what we're gonna see here is that John was a messenger from Jesus. He was a messenger from God who was preparing the way for Jesus. And not everybody understood his message all the time. In fact, they were kind of confused as to who John really was, John the Baptist. And so we're gonna pick up this passage in John chapter 1, and I want you guys to follow along with me. It says this in verse 19. Now this was John's testimony when the Jewish leaders in Jerusalem sent priests and Levites to ask him who he was. He did not fail to confess, but confessed freely. "I am not the Messiah," he said. They asked him, "Then who are you? Are you Elijah?" He said, "I am not." "Are you the prophet?" He answered, "No." Finally, they said, "Who are you? Give us an answer to take back to those who sent us. What do you say about yourself?" And in verse 23, John replied in the words of Isaiah the prophet, "I am the voice of the one calling in the wilderness. Make straight the way for the Lord." So there are three things here that I want to point out to you that we learn from John's response, okay? The first is John knew who he was not. John owned the fact that he was not the Messiah. Now that word Messiah, I know it's kind of like a word like we don't use very often, but it just means anointed one, savior basically. And John knew that he was not the Messiah and he didn't need to take anybody else's identity and place that on himself. Students, don't try and steal somebody else's identity and place that on yourself and pretend that that is going to help you find meaning and purpose. God made you unique. He made you distinct. He made you different for a specific purpose. Now, what else do we know? John not only knew who he was not, number two, John knew who he was. He understood that he was created with a distinct purpose, and he was the only one who could fulfill that purpose. Now, this is something very important I want you to understand. God not only has created you for a specific and distinct purpose, but there is no one else on the planet, no one else in the universe who can do what God has created you to do. Nobody can fulfill your purpose other than you. You're the only person on the planet who can fulfill the purpose God has for you. Now, I don't know about you, that makes me like super excited. It's kind of scary to think about, like, man, that's a lot of responsibility. But at the same time, it's exhilarating to think that there, I am literally the only person on the planet who can fulfill the purpose that God has for me. It makes me want to be like, let's go. Yes, I got this. I am going to do this through God. God is going to do it through me. It's so exciting. Nobody else can do that other than me. Why? Because God has designed it specifically for me. And God has designed and given you purpose and meaning that only you can fulfill. And number three, John not only knew who he was not, he not only knew who he was, but John also knew how he fit into God's plan. You see, that doesn't mean that John just knew the future or that he knew everything that was going to happen. But what he did know and understand is that there's a much bigger picture. God has a much bigger plan than what we can see right in front of us. And students, God has a much bigger plan and purpose for your life, one that involves you understanding God's greater plan for all of eternity. You see, when they asked John again, "Who are you?" So we can go back and report. This is what John said in verse 23. "I am the voice of the one calling in the wilderness. Make way the path of the Lord." That reply sounded very familiar to them. Why? Because he was quoting the Bible to them. He quoted a prophecy that was written hundreds of years before in Isaiah chapter 40, verse 3. See, when John gave them that answer, he was basically saying, "I'm fulfilling this prophecy. This prophecy was written about me." And this is a very important aspect that I want you to see and I want you to understand, okay? John the Baptist discovered his identity and discovered his purpose when he studied the Word and knew the Word. You see, last week, stay with me, okay? Last week, we talked about how Jesus is the Word, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. So literally, God's Word was born when Jesus came to the earth. And what John does here is he looks at the Bible, he looks to the Word of God, he looks to Jesus, and ultimately, he finds his identity there and his purpose there in the Word of God. Students, you will never discover your purpose and meaning in life apart from God's Word. If you really want to know and understand, what is it that God's called me to do? Who has God created me to be? Why did God make me like this? If you want to know those answers, you have to know Jesus. Not just know about Jesus, not just know about the Word, but you have to truly know the Word. You have to truly know Jesus. That was some of the most profound words that John the Baptist could have ever said. And what was it? It was Scripture. And he's teaching us that is what it looks like to find our identity and our purpose. Now, I want to close this morning by reading for you in another passage in Isaiah, in chapter 43. Now, these words were written by God through the prophet of Isaiah to his chosen people of Israel. However, even though they were written for the people of Israel, they really do describe God's love for all of his children, including you and me. And so as I read this passage, I want you to really focus in on these words of God's love and care and affirmation to his chosen people. Now read with me in Isaiah 43, starting in verse 1. It says, "But now this is what the Lord says. He who created you, Jacob, he who formed you, O Israel, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have summoned or called you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. When you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. The flames will not set you ablaze. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I give Egypt for your ransom, Cush and Saba in your stead, since you are precious and honored in my sight. And because I love you, I will give people in exchange for you, nations in exchange for your life. Do not be afraid, for I am with you. I will bring your children from the east and gather from the west. I will say to the north, give them up, and to the south, do not hold them back. Bring my sons from afar, my daughters from the ends of the earth." And in verse 7, he finishes with this, "Everyone who is called by name, by my name, whom I created for my glory, whom I formed and made." You see, students, God, the creator of the universe, the one who created the galaxies, the planets, the stars, and names the stars in the sky, the one who created every living being, every plant, every flower, every tree, every animal, every living human being that has ever lived, every human that is living now, and every human that has yet to be even born. God has created all of them, and he created you, and he formed you, and he loves you. Students, God has made you distinct, and he has given you a purpose and a meaning, one that only you can fulfill. So be encouraged by these words, by the truth of God's word, that he loves you, that you don't have to be afraid, that you don't have to be what society tells you you need to be, that you don't have to be what your friend at PE tells you you should be. You don't have to dress like anyone else. You can be who God has created you to be. Why? Because God has made you distinct.